doing this today, so surprise. But I thought it was just really important that Demi got words from somebody that just thinks the absolute world of her, so. I firstly want to say a huge congratulations to you both and officially welcome Kyle into our family, even though it feels like you've been around forever. Imagined so many different ways of how today's speech would go, but I think I always knew deep down that I wouldn't be able to find the words to express just how important and how perfect Demi is in my eyes. So I'm gonna try and give it a go. And I did everything together when we were little, and I've had her by my side ever since. We may not be sisters, but we have laughed, loved, and fought like sisters do. We've trailed the hair off each other many a time, but we're still together. I have been so emotional for the build up today. Watching Demi prepare for today has made me extremely emotional. And at first I didn't really know why, but then when I thought about it, I thought about the fact that we're living the dream that we had as little girls. We're both living in the dream that we had when we were 9 and 11. There may not be that many things that are the same today, so Demi isn't sticking her fake nails on with blue tack. Me and her aren't stomping around in Auntie Helen's high heels, and we haven't quite managed to choreograph a dance to do for everybody at the end of the night, but who knows. But the one thing that has stayed the same is how much I love and care for Demi, and how much I will continue to look up to her for the rest of my life. Demi is the most loving, most caring, and kindest person I've ever met, and I always knew that the person she would end up with would be the luckiest guy on earth. And he is that guy. The guy that she used to show me pictures of on Bebo. Yeah. The guy that used to make her smile when he texts. And the guy that's just about as crazy as her when she's drunk. And the guy that I watched my best friend fall in love with. Thank you.
like to warmly welcome you all to Belfast Castle and to this very important and special occasion for Kyle and Demi. It is good to see you all here today to join in their celebrations, but you will also be taking part in today's ceremony by listening to and witnessing the two legal declarations that must be made by Kyle and Demi. After me, please. I call upon
these persons here present
to witness
that I Kyle Allen
do take you Demi Fellows to be my lawful wedded wife. Demi, please after me. I call upon
these persons here present
To witness that I, Demi Fellows, do take you, Kyle Allen,
to be my lawful wedded husband.
Kyle, will you solemnly promise that you will always protect Demi with your utmost care, that you will honour and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, and that in all things you will be to Demi a faithful and loving husband?
I will.
Demi, will you solemnly promise that you will always protect Kyle with your utmost care, that you will honour and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, and that in all things you will be to Kyle a faithful and loving wife?
I will.
Demi, I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love. And of our marriage today. And Demi, Kyle, I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love. And of our marriage today. Kyle and Demi, as a token of the contract into which you have entered, these rings are given and received. Today you have pledged your commitment to each other. May you always begin each day with fresh hope in your hearts. May you have happiness by being happy with one another, and may you find love in loving one another. By virtue of the covenants made in my presence as the Deputy Registrar of Marriages and before your witnesses, I have great pleasure in declaring that you, Kyle William Allen, and you, Demi Fellows, are now joined together in matrimony in accordance with the law. May be the first to congratulate you. May kiss the bride. Thank you.
I'd like to take this opportunity to friendly welcome Demi and the family.
Thanks,
Rob. And thank Colin and Helen for welcoming Kelly to your family.
Aww.
They say you don't lose a daughter, but in fact you gain a son. All I can say is God love you. Now, as most of you know, Kelly's always enjoyed the finer things of life. It's nice holidays, designer clothes, fancy cars, none of that compared to what you have right here in Demi. Kayla, I just want to say, on behalf of me and your mummy, how very proud you make us every day, the wee gentleman you've turned into. So Kayla and Demi, I'd like to wish you all the best in your journey ahead as man and wife.
Thank you, Rob.
So if you join me in raising your glasses, to toast to the bride and groom.
I just want to say, Demi, you look absolutely fucking stunning, as always. Yeah. Listen, you deserve all the happiness in the world. I don't know why the fuck you're settling, but you're doing it. Kayla, you too. You're a wee sexy minx, you always were. Do you know what? I feel like a proud dad just watching it. It's like, I watched it grow from a boy. Dear boy. You've never really fucking grew, you dick. You're still a fucking agent. No, my John, you've turned into a man today, and that's all thanks to Demi. Listen, no, look, I'm so happy for the both of you. I say, look, both of you is the best. I wish you all the best. A long and happy marriage. And thank you for letting me to be a wee part of your big day.
But reading this speech, I realised that me and Kate have nothing in common. None. I'm big, you're small. I'm funny, you're not. I'm good looking. You know where I'm going. So we all put a wee toast up, please. For my best mate and my beautiful wife, I wish you all happiness in the world.
Cheers.
Have a good one, mate.
Hi, gorgeous is my fucking wife. Yeah. Wee sugar tits on you. Genuinely, like, I swear to God, I sometimes think I talk a lot of your shit, no, but I feel suspicious. But anyway, holy good fuck, you are gorgeous. But genuinely, listen, you have no idea how fucking happy I am with you all here. Demi is one lucky wee shit. Slap me in the arse, sir, babes. Nah, but I'm only joking though. Listen, I couldn't have met a better girl. I genuinely couldn't. I love you to bits. I really, really do love you to bits. I do. Is that microphone hear me? No?